Hello students, good morning. So today we are going to start the next topic, that is inheritance, molecular basis of inheritance. But before going to start this topic, let us have recapitulation. Let us have the recapitulation about the previous lesson. In the previous lesson we have learned about the genetics. In that genetics topic, Mendelism also we have learned, where Mendel, we have learned about that Mendel, under Mendelism we have learned that the characters are inherited through the factors. So Mendel, who was Mendel then? So Mendel was the father of genetics, as we know that. So as he explained that characters are inherited through the factors. So what are factors then? So factors, today we are calling them as genes, but Mendel called them as the factors. So factors are responsible for the transmission of characters from parents to the offspring, that we have understood under Mendelism in the previous lesson. But in this chapter, what we are going to learn, in this chapter, characters are inherited. Then what is the meaning of characters? Characters may be either external or internal. It may be phenotypic or genotypic. Okay, so those characters which are present in our parents, they are transmitted from parents to their offspring or their progeny. So that is known as inheritance. So we will also understand what is molecular there. So molecular, here it refers to characters, those characters, either phenotypic character or genotypic characters, they are inherited at molecular level. So again question comes here, what is the meaning of molecular level? So molecular level is nothing but, it may be DNA or RNA. So these togetherly known as nucleic acids. So today we are also learn about the way these nucleic acids are present. So to understand all these aspects, let us, we have to define what are nucleic acids, where they are present, what is their chemical nature. The detailed aspect of all that we are going to learn. So apart from that, so let me explain you about to understand the inheritance of characters from parents to offspring, where exactly the nucleic acids are present, that we have to understand. So take for example a cell. So our body is made up of number of cells, and within each cell there lies a nucleus, and within the nucleus, some thread-like structures are present, and those structures are known as chromosomes. So if you isolate the nucleus outside the cell and see under the microscope, then you will come to observe the chromosomes. And these chromosomes, then what are these chromosomes? So if you expand them, they look like this. So after isolating nucleus from the cell, the new chromosomes are isolated, they are separated, and each chromosome consists of chromatids, and this is the structure of a rough diagram of a chromosome, where the chromosome is made up of chromatids. Okay, and if you expand, still you expand this chromosome and we analyze the structure of the chromosome, when we magnify it and see under the microscope, we see the structure of our DNA. So this is nothing but the DNA, which is responsible for controlling our body characters. So whatever characters today we are having, or you we possess, either genetical characters, either phenotypic character, external character, or internal characters, all those characters are controlled by this DNA itself. So hence the topic name, as it indicates, molecular means the DNA, which is the basis of the inheritance of the characters. So DNA or RNA. So majority of the organism, if you observe the majority of the organism, 99% of the organisms, their body characters are controlled by this DNA itself. And without DNA, the characters are not transmitted. So these characters are transmitted from our parents, our ancestors, our parents, and their in the forthcoming generation also, they are carried. Okay, so this is all about the introduction to this topic.